what happens in real life. Which one is me? At school, I'm super sporty and trendy. But online, I can totally geek out on manga and the ukulele. If I wear my favorite tie-dye jacket, I might get one compliment.
Nice jacket.
But if I post myself wearing it online, boom, compliment overload. Then again, if I fail IRL, maybe one person will see it and then quickly forget. But if I fail on social media, everybody sees it, and it sticks around forever.
Keeping track of two yous with one brain can be exhausting.
So how do you stay sane and be the best in both worlds? First, you need to understand why you and your friends behave the way you do online. And to do that, we're gonna play a little game.
Let's in real life.
Oh.
Popular picks.
Take a look at these two social media posts. All you have to do is decide which one you like better. Selfie cat, which got over 2.5 million likes, or the chill kangaroo, which only got 13 likes. So, got your pick? Now check out which photos some other people chose.
I like the cat picture taking a selfie. I like the cat selfie one.
I really like the cat selfie.
That looks like the cat is the boss of all of them, so I think it's more funny than the other one.
Interesting. So far, all the volunteers picked Clicky Kitty. Do you think there's anything we can do to get more votes for Chillaroo? Let's see what happens when we make one small change.
Yeah, I like the kangaroo.
I like the kangaroo better, because he seems pretty dope.
My vote's for the kangaroo.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, what did we change? The answer may surprise you. When we wanted volunteers to pick the cat, we showed them this version of the photos, where the cat had 2.5 million likes, and the kangaroo only had a handful. But when we wanted them to pick the kangaroo, we showed them the kangaroo was the one with 2.5 million likes, while poor kitty only had a few. So why would an already popular photo with tons of likes make more people like it? Here to help explain is our science friend, Allie Ward.
When it comes to humans, doing and liking what's popular is something we're hardwired to do. It's why popular performers enjoy more fame and fortune, and popular brands and products sell more merchandise. So it only makes sense that given an uncertain choice, people tend to follow the herd and do what's popular. That's because copying the behavior of others is a practical, adaptable behavior.